Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the NewTek YouTube channel. Today I would like to show you a powerful feature within the TriCaster DDR called Show On. This feature allows you to play back single clips from your DDR with transitions and customized playback speeds on your program output or mix effects with just a touch of a button. So this would be perfect for, say, instant replays or single clips that you'd like to play into your broadcast without disrupting the normal flow of your playlist. So, let me show you how it's done, son! Alright, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and I only have four inputs coming in right now, and I am recording my broadcast, and I have my instant replays selected. If you need to review how to do that, just consult with our YouTube channel, youtube.com/newtekinc. But I'm going to go ahead and watch this video here, and let's wait for a replay to show up. Not quite. Let's see what else happens. I'll go ahead and fast forward this. This is boring. Oh, a little razzle-dazzle. There we go. Hey, all right, so let's take an instant replay of that by clicking on the replay button. And now you'll see that I have my clip of my instant replay here in my DDR1. So let's say that this particular DDR bin is filled with a whole bunch of different commercials, things like that, that I would normally play. And something happened very instantaneously that I want to show really quick. Instead of going through and say, all right, let me queue up this clip, go ahead and grab my DDR and a preview, find a transition for it and do an auto transition to it, I can use the Show On feature, which is at the bottom of your DDRs. So you'll see you have your controls here in the middle, but over here is a little option for our Show On feature. All right, and to use that, let's go ahead and click on this gear icon and show you the different configurations for it. So the first one is going to be Auto 2, and currently I have selected Program. But if I select this drop down, you'll see that I can also select one of my mix effects from this list as well. All right, so I'm gonna leave it on Program for now. And then I can also change the speed in which that clip plays out as. So let's just put 75%. And then the transitions, I currently have it selected as current. And what that means is it will use a transition that I'm currently using loaded into my switcher, which is this guitar. I know that doesn't make sense right now, but you know, whatever. Okay, so let's go ahead and play that back. So I have this selected over here. And let's just say I want to play a quick instant replay of, oh, that was awesome. Let's go ahead and play it out by clicking on this button and check it out. It will use a transition, my guitar transition. And then it will play this clip back in slow motion. All right, there you go. Kicking it out. And go. And as soon as that clip is done playing, it will use this transition, that guitar transition, and go back to the input that I was using before. So boom, see, check that out. And that's all I had to do. So that way I don't have to interrupt what I normally have in my DDR playlist. It will just do that automatically. All right, now let me show you a few other things here. Let's go back into the Show On feature. And in the transition side, let's do something different. So I can either do a cut, which, you know, self-explanatory there. It'll just do a cut whenever I do that transition to that and hit the button. But let's say let's use these blinds for coming in and the transition out. Click custom and we'll use twirl for going out. All right, and then let's leave it at 75%. All right, so we'll have that same clip selected here. Let's go ahead and play that by clicking on the Show On button here. And then you'll see, there we go, same clip playing back. It used the blinds transition, and when it gets to the end of it, it will do the blinds transition out, and then my program switcher will go back to my previous input, which is input number 3. So cool, that is in, and clip's going down to the ending here. And bam, there we go. And then I can resume my normal broadcast. So it doesn't interrupt what I have in my playlists, etc. So that makes it really cool to just say, bam, just hit that button. Great for instant replays or, for example, if you have like a presentation going on and somebody gives you a file and you just need to play it real quick, that's a good way to do it without having to go through and just hit all these different buttons and your different transitions, etc. So I just showed you how to use the Show On feature on the program output, but you can also send the Show On clip that you want to use to, say, a mix effect, which would be great for, say, like a secondary monitor, for example. So let me show you how to do that. All right, so back in the TriCaster TC1 interface, I've already shown you how to use the show on feature for your program, but now I want to show you how to do that for the mix effect side of things. So I'm going to open up my mix effect number 2, and I want to show you real quick that I have a virtual set shot in here right now, and this particular feature is not going to work if you're using this setup as a virtual set. So for example, let me go down back to my DDR here, and I'll go to auto and select ME2. And if I click on this button, nothing is going to happen. I'm clicking this repeatedly and nothing is happening because this is only going to be used in a switcher scenario. So if you're using your mix effect as a virtual set, not going to work. But if you use it as a secondary switcher, which you can do by loading in a transition, for example, like this, or let me choose another transition. Let's use this burst wipe here. Then that's how it's going to be able to work. All right, so let's go back down over here to show on. And again, I have from this drop down selected my mix effect number 2. Speed is this, and the transition is current. Now, when I say current, it's going to be the transition that is loaded into mix effect number 2, which is this flash burst transition. Okay, so let's go ahead and click on that button and check it out. Over in your preview window. And there's that clip that I have for my instant replay. And then when it's done, it will again use that selected transition to go back to whatever I have on the B row of this particular switcher. And there it goes. Flash back, and we're back to our normal game. Show on is a cool feature when you need to play a clip quickly and go back to your regularly scheduled broadcast. I hope this video helps expand your NewTek knowledge, and for more nuggets of NewTek wisdom, subscribe to the NewTek YouTube channel at youtube.com/NewTekInc. And for more information on NewTek products and services, talk to your local reseller or visit newtek.com. Also visit newtek.tv where you can see all the latest NewTek product updates, interviews with TriCaster users, third-party developers, and a whole lot more. And if you're posting your work using NewTek products on social media, use the hashtags NewTek or TriCaster. I see you all out there, and you'll get a like from me for sure. I'd love to see what you all are working on, so keep posting. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time for another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.